Ray Allen fires away, and there's a three-pointer.
In 2010, we would have beat the Lakers if I wouldn't have got injured.
Great 8 points. Great screen by Garnett there. Kobe Bryant.
All I know is that we had a 14-point lead going into the fourth quarter, and we should have won that game.
In Game 6 of the 2010 NBA Finals, Kendrick Perkins tore his ACL, ruling him out of the all-important Game 7. For Celtics fans, that injury still stings. Perkins has openly talked about how much he could have helped in that final game, especially when it came down to defense and rebounding, two areas the Celtics struggled with.
All I know is that we had a 14-point lead going into the fourth quarter, and we should have won that game. Like, whether I played or not, we had a 14-point lead going into the fourth quarter, and we should have won the game. I thought at that time the Lakers' willpower got them through. Kobe had, 16 rebounds, 8 offensive or something crazy like that. I mean, that was it. They only shot under 40% from the field, defense wasn't the problem. It was just who wanted to do the most, and I thought they actually went and took it from us.
When you break it down, he's absolutely right. The Celtics were crushed on the boards, losing the rebounding battle 53-40. The Lakers grabbed 23 offensive rebounds, while the Celtics managed just 8. That difference was huge, especially in a close game. Let's take a closer look at the numbers. The Celtics had the perfect game plan to limit Kobe Bryant, holding him to just 6-for-24 shooting. But where they fell short was on the inside. Pau Gasol was unstoppable, putting up 19 points and grabbing 18 rebounds, and the Celtics gave up 38 points in the paint. Perkins believed his interior presence could have made all the difference, especially when it came to taking some of the load off Kevin Garnett, who had to battle Andrew Bynum and Gasol by himself.
Just think about it. We was up 14 points in Game 7 going into the fourth quarter, and they just out-rebounded us. KG was worn down from banging with Bynum and Gasol, and that's why I would have took the load off of him.
And honestly, he probably would have. With Perkins in the lineups, the Celtics had a much more physical front court. His ability to box out, defend the post, and provide extra rebounding could have been the key to sealing the win for Boston. Perkins also shared that he believes he should have had 2 rings by now.
I think in 2010, we would have beat the Lakers if I wouldn't have gotten injured. Just remember, right, when healthy, our starting 5 never lost the playoff series. So, you know, we had one game, and we had to win one game out of 2. And I figured we was going to get the job done if I would have played. I know for sure I would have had 2 rings up in my trophy case.
And that's a bold statement, but it does hold weight. The Celtics' core starting 5 of Perkins, Garnett, Paul Pierce, Ray Allen, and Rajon Rondo had an incredible record when they were healthy. That Game 7 loss and just a 4-point defeat, and given how close it was, it's easy to understand why Perkins feels his presence could have been the difference between winning and losing. It's one of those moments that will always make Celtics fans wonder, what if? After losing that final series, the Celtics knew they had to make some changes. The following season, they brought in more size to counter teams with strong front courts, especially ones like the Lakers. They added Jermaine O'Neal, Shaquille O'Neal, and even Nenad Nistrik to bolster their interior defense. Jeff Green also joined the roster, offering some depth at the forward position. Unfortunately, it didn't work out well for the Celtics in 2011. They didn't make it back to the finals, and the Lakers didn't either. That 2010 series ended up being the last time these two historic franchises faced off for a championship. So, what do you guys think? Could Kendrick Perkins have made all the difference in that Game 7 and helped the Celtics win another championship? Or was it just the Lakers' time to shine? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more upcoming videos and NBA content. My name is Damian Peters. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.